here we are, ladies and gentlemen. The final Scream movie review that I actually have to record. And then, of course, like I said before, stay behind after I finish this initial review, because I am going to be also porting over my reviews of Scream 5 and 6 from Cynical Saint 77. So, you'll get to see my thoughts on those movies as well as this one. So you have all my thoughts about this entire franchise leading up to whenever the heck Saw 7 comes out. Whenever Scream 7 comes out. I have no idea when. They say it's supposed to be a Christmas movie, so I assume it's going to be in December and November of next year, but we'll wait and see. What's up? What's happening? What's going on? Welcome back to Animation Station. Yo, this is for anything and everything animation. Welcome back to Revenge of 31 Days of Horror, and welcome to our final Scream movie that I have to actually record. Welcome to my review of Scream 4, the final movie of Wes Craven's career before his sad passing, and in my opinion, a perfect textbook example of how to correctly resurrect a franchise. Yes, it took until 2011 for us to actually get another Scream movie, but trust me when I say it was worth it. This is leagues better than 3, and it's about on the same quality level as 2. So, yeah, we have a pretty good bit to talk about today. So, without any more further ados or delays, here's my written review, and then I'll talk about my overall thoughts afterwards. Let's finish off another series of this horror movie marathon with the last installment that I haven't already previously reviewed, Scream 4. After how sadly terrible the third one turned out, due to its many, many problems in production, this was a much-needed reset for the franchise, and tragically, the final film directed by Wes Craven before he sadly passed away shortly after its release. He really was a true visionary and an all-around nice guy, and arguably one of the greatest directors of all time. May he forever rest in peace, and I'll continue to do my part to keep his legacy immortal, along with the rest of the horror movie community, passing these movies down to the next generation, for their generation to pass to their generation, and just keep it alive for as long as possible. Sorry for getting so serious, here's the actual review. The story's pretty good, the kills are brutal and very gory, like, one of the characters gets outright eviscerated, and it's even more vicious and gory than it was in the original. The characters, both old and new, are great, the twists are pretty good, the meta-commentary on remakes is clever and surprisingly still relevant to this very day. The music is good enough, it's not, like, the most memorable, amazing music you ever hear, but it's good enough, it works for the movie. The cold open, while a bit confusing, is still pretty fun, the pacing is solid, the runtime's pretty good, the directing is great, and the setting, while familiar, is still good, and it still feels right at home in the franchise. However, there's still a few issues. The plot itself is a little bit confusing, the killer reveal is pretty damn weak, the final scene in the hospital feels tacked on, and while the runtime is pretty good overall, it could be shortened by at least 20 minutes. Like, if you cut out that whole hospital scene, I bet you the movie would be a lot better. Overall, though, while not quite a great movie, unfortunately, it's still a really enjoyable one and a very solid one for Mr. Craven to go out on. And after how bad 3 was, this was a definite, much-needed breath of fresh air. Definitely recommended, but still not as great as the first 2 films or the latest 2 movies to follow after it. Yeah, that's a little spoiler for you. I love Scream 5 and 6. I almost said Saw. Why do I keep saying Saw, damn it? Final verdict is a strong 7 out of 10, and I definitely recommend it. If you haven't seen it yet, check it out. It's better than most of those horror forequels out there. Looking at you, Dream Master. Okay, that's it. Thank you guys for watching. Please enjoy my reviews of Scream 5 and 6. See you next time.
Welcome home, Sydney. Sorry, bad impression. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Cynical Saint 77, your place for movies, music, pretty much anything live action related or R-rated that I can't talk about on the other channel. And this would be such an occasion because today we're taking a look at the newest installment in the Scream franchise. Whatever you want to call it, Scream 2022, Scream 5, Five Cream, whatever the fuck you want to call it. And I'm here to tell you once and for all if the shitty January horror movie curse has finally been broken. So let's go ahead and get started by talking about the positives of this feature. First of all, biggest plus right off the bat is that the new characters are actually decent. Like, they're not fodder, just one, well, they're not all fodder, some of them are. Just to fill up the kill count, at least not most of them. And the acting was surprisingly good from some of them. And even though they do have the legacy characters in there, they still feel like the center of the story, and they did it very, very well. My next positive is the cinematography. There were so many great shots throughout the entire film. Whether it's like in the dark with Ghostface up like this from the trailer, or that hospital scene with the contrasts of the little lights in the, like, the trophy case from the rest of the dark hallway. Oh, it's so good. And then pro number three, the kills. Holy shit, these kills are brutal, they're gory, they're violent, and they're so fucking good. Like, these are great kills. These are some of the best in the entire series. I mean, it's not as good as Tatum with boobs stuck in the door getting crushed by a garage door. Nowhere near as good. But it's still really good. Like, all the kills in this movie are really good. Yes, they're stabbings. Yes, some of them can feel very, very repetitive. But it's not like Scream 3, where they felt half-assed and just thrown in there to let you know that this character's dead, you gotta move on. No. The kills in this movie are fucking brutal. My fourth positive is the legacy characters themselves. At first, I thought this was just gonna be ripping off the Halloween 2018 formula by bringing back these legacy characters, but then making the other characters complete shit. And I'm happy to report that that's actually not the case. Yes, the legacy characters are here, and they do a really damn good job, especially David Arquette, who gives, I think, the best performance of his entire career. But the other two in here, Neve Campbell, Courtney Cox, they're still just as great as ever, and Neve Campbell always finds ways to keep adding more layers to her character to make her more three-dimensional and not, you know, like your standard final girl. And then my final and fifth positive is the mystery itself. Yes, you can see it coming from a mile away, but it's still executed so fucking well. And there's some self-referential humor. There's a lot of great jokes. That brings me to my sixth positive, the writing. The writing in this movie, for the most part, is surprisingly sharp. There were a lot of self-referential callbacks to not only horror movies in general, but the actual Scream series, so, you know, meta-humor. There was some legitimately funny jokes, like when the one scene where the one girl, I forget her name, the one supposed to know everything about horror movies directly insults and calls out Dewey, who's sitting right on the couch next to them. That scene was fucking hilarious. It had me laughing my ass off for a good while. And even in the serious moments, like, it works really, really well. And I think all the beats were done well, and nothing feels like a throwaway. Except for a few things. And that's gonna bring me to my mixed aspects of the film. My first one is, like I said, the mystery is very, very predictable. Like, you can tell just from basic cliches of the other Screams that this is the killer, and then this is the second killer. Like, you can see it from a fucking mile away if you've been watching these movies for years, and especially when you binge-watch them back to back to back to back, like I did. I skipped three, because three is dog shit and doesn't matter. What was I going to say? But yeah, mystery can be seen from a mile away. And then the other mixed aspect, and this is a spoiler-free review, but there is one death in this movie that's either going to hit you in the heart because you don't want to see them die, or it's going to piss you the fuck off because you think they should have just lived through the whole thing. And my final mixed aspect is its message on toxic fandom. It's executed well. And I think it was a really good thing for them to comment on, because there are a lot of toxic fandoms for pretty much any franchise. And they did a great job addressing it and bringing it up and telling people that this is not okay, you should not do this. But at the same time, it kind of feels sort of hypocritical because of the ending, like the final act. And while the final act is satisfying, it feels a bit rushed. Now let's get to my two bad aspects from this movie. My first one is the first person that dies. He's in the trailer, so it's not a spoiler. But it was, I'm not going to fucking sugarcoat it. It was an obvious jab at Morgan Wallen. I mean, think about it. He's a racist. He has that country look, long hair, the cut-off plaid, the boots, the pants. Yep, they were taking a dig at Morgan Wallen, and I am not okay with that, because say what you will about him, but that was definitely going a step too far, and when I realized it, it did piss me off. And the other part that pisses me off, the other part that pisses me off is the ending. Now, like I said, the ending is satisfying and it's well done, but it feels so fucking rushed. Like, you can tell they were running out of time and had to bring everything together in a somewhat satisfying way, but it felt rushed and it did feel half-assed. I mean, it doesn't harm the whole movie, but it's just something to point out. So, now that we've gone through the positives, the mixed, and the negatives, time for the final verdict. What is my final verdict on good old Five Cream? It's fucking great, man. I had a great time watching this movie, and I think it did a great job tying in pretty much all the movies together. Even though, again, 3 doesn't really fucking matter, because it doesn't really serve much of a point with this movie specifically. So, what I recommend you guys to do is to watch the original, watch 2, and watch 4. Watch those ones. You don't have to watch 3. 3 barely has any fucking meaning in this movie at all. So, you can skip 3. You don't have to watch that garbage again. Outside of maybe the Carrie Fisher scene, because that scene was legitimately funny. So, my final verdict on this newest bloodbath. Like I said, it's fucking great. But do I give it an 8 or do I give it a 9? That's a very tough question. There are aspects about it that I fucking love, like the cinematography, the direction from the Ready or Not people, its execution, and the fact that it's actually a good 5th installment of a series, which is very fucking rare. But it has things about it that just piss me off and that do make me a bit hesitant. So do I give an 8 or a 9? Fuck it. It's a damn good movie. It broke the January horror movie curse. So for that alone, 9 out of 10. Absolute fucking 9 out of 10. If you have not watched this movie yet, you absolutely need to. Scream fans, you're gonna fucking love it. Horror fans, you're gonna love it. And it is one of the standouts in a very shitty January. Which again, blows my mind, because usually with January, it's always the horror movies that are shit, and the rest of them that are decent to good. But this year, it was like flipped around, because the horror movie turned out to be fucking excellent. And then the rest of them turned out to be mediocre to outright shit. So, yeah, that's January for you. And I'm glad that it was reversed, but maybe one day we will get January movies that don't suck ass. Like we'll get a genuinely good January all the way through. But I don't know. But that's going to do it for this review. Thank you guys for watching. Look forward to more reviews very soon, because next up, we got to talk about Moonfall. And that's not going to be a fun one. But, like I said, horror movie fans, you're going to fucking love this movie. And fans themselves, you will be mixed on it, but I'm sure you'll still have fun either way. It's still a fun film. So with all that said, thank you guys for watching. Look forward to the Moonfall review / rant coming out very soon today. But until then, I'm Jack Small of the Animation Station. Thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you later. Take care.
Damn. I mean, I knew this movie was going to be good, but I was not expecting this good. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Cynical Scene 77, and Scream 6 is fucking awesome. It reshapes its own formula and really pushes its boundaries. Now, is it better than the first one? Unfortunately, I have to say no. I'm going to explain why, don't worry. But of course, just starting with the positives. The kills are as bloody and brutal as you're hearing about from other critics. The acting in here, for the most part, is very great. The characters that we know and love from that last movie are still here, and still great, and still accounted for. The execution of the kills is great. They absolutely make very good use of the New York city setting. There's lots of variety, there's a great story here, and it continues on from Scream 5 very, very well. Like, those things I can all say right off the bat without any hesitation. Not only that, the pacing is actually much faster than you'd think. Because this is a movie that's under 2 hours. Heck, it's barely over an hour and a half. So, yeah, this movie just kicks ass, guys. It is so, so freaking good. I love this one. It is just as good as Scream 5. So why is it not as good? Because the villain twists his shit. That's the big reason why it's not better. Because the villain twist at the end is recycled dog shit. That's the worst part of this movie, is the recycled plot twist at the very end. I'm not going to say why or what it recycles, because that's a spoiler, but when you see it, you see it. And I also feel like some characters could have used a bit more screen time than others, but they did get development, they did get a good bit. And not to mention, you still have those characters that just act like dumb slasher fodder, so. But it's a slasher, I mean, kind of to expect that. So I'd say this is on the level of Scream 5, but not better. Final verdict is a 9 out of 10. It is absolutely going on the best list this year, and I am excited to see what Scream 7 has in store, because that has already been greenlit, according to 3C. So, yeah, pretty exciting. Pretty great fucking Scream movie, and I'm glad these movies are just keeping up that high quality, especially after how many years we had to wait for Scream 5. Like, he works so well. Like, yes, I don't think the meta commentary for the actual motive of the killers makes a lot of sense. But outside of that and the ending twist being shit, the rest of this movie is great. And you absolutely need to go fucking see it. Especially if you are a Scream fan. And especially if you're a horror fan. And even gorehounds can go, because there is a good bit of blood in this movie. So, yeah. Great, great Scream movie. Another really great Scream movie. So close to perfect, but just misses the mark by just a tad. But I can understand why some people think it might be worse, or some people just aren't into these new Scream movies. I understand that, but This is my opinion, and in my opinion, it's great. Plain and simple. Alright. See you guys in the next review.